Hyperuricemia, or high uric acid in gout, are rising around the world. This has to do with the increasing affluence of the world and the consumption of richer foods. Because of this, this rise is expected to continue in the foreseeable future. But besides swelling in the joints and painful joints, is there a more ominous consequence of the increasing levels of uric acid around the world? We'll take a closer look at this in this video. What does gout have to do with the heart? Isn't gout supposed to be a disease that affects our big toes and other joints in the body? Well, it turns out that high serum uric acid levels, hyperuricemia, and gout have an important connection with the heart. Hyperuricemia and gout have occupied center stage in several diseases that affect the longevity of millions of people in the world today. Depending on the part of the world that you live and the genetic makeup of the population, hyperuricemia and gout can affect up to 20 to 30% of the population, and the incidence is rising. This is because as the nations of the world develop and people begin to consume more affluent diets, the incidence and prevalence of gout rises. So what is gout? Gout arises when monosodium urate crystals deposit in and around the joints in our bodies, leading to inflammation and severe pain. Monosodium urate crystals deposit in the joints when the levels of uric acid in the blood rise above a certain level. That level is 7 milligrams per deciliter in men and 6 milligrams per deciliter in women. But what is uric acid? Uric acid is the breakdown product of purines in the body. Purines are these molecules that build our RNA and our DNA so that all the cells in the body have purines. We also intake purines in the diets that we eat. And some foods have high concentrations of purines that can build up in the body and lead to hyperuricemia and gout. But what has this got to do with the heart? Hyperuricemia and gout have been found to be risk factors for atherosclerosis, hardening of the arteries, and heart disease. We now recognize that there's a strong association between hyperuricemia and gout and diseases such as high blood pressure and kidney disease and metabolic syndrome and insulin resistance and heart disease and heart attacks and strokes. Many studies have confirmed these associations. Just how high serum uric acid affects the arteries and causes atherosclerosis and hardening of the arteries, we are only now beginning to understand. Up until now, we believed that uric acid crystals were simply crystals that deposited in the joints as inert molecules and caused inflammation in the joints. But now, scientists have uncovered several processes in the body in which uric acid plays an active role. Uric acid can cause inflammation in the walls of the arteries, and this inflammation can lead to the formation of atherosclerotic plaque and atherosclerosis, hardening of the arteries. Uric acid can induce the production of reactive oxygen species in the walls of the arteries, and reactive oxygen species can trigger the release of chemokines and cytokines, inflammatory molecules in the body. As a matter of fact, uric acid itself on the inside of cells can trigger the secretion of cytokines and chemokines, inflammatory cytokines and chemokines. And this can lead to generalized inflammation in the body, which we now know can cause hypertension and metabolic syndrome and insulin resistance and diabetes. All of these are well-known risk factors for cardiovascular disease, heart attacks, and strokes. Uric acid can also cause the dysfunction of the cells lining the arteries, known as the endothelium. leading to a decreased production of nitric oxide, which is a powerful vasodilator, a molecule that dilates the arteries. And it can also lead to an increased production of endothelin, which is a molecule that causes vasoconstriction or narrowing of the arteries. The end result is the narrowing of arteries and atherosclerosis. But there's some good news. Scientists have discovered that the drugs that we use to treat hyperuricemia and gout can prevent heart attacks and strokes in people who have cardiovascular disease and gout. Unfortunately, however, the most recent study, the all-heart study, concluded that this does not apply to people with cardiovascular disease who do not have gout. If we want to prevent heart disease from gout and hyperuricemia, apart from using these medications, we can also avoid those foods that have high purine contents and that can raise the purine levels in our bodies, such as seafood, scallops, and herrings, and anchovies. Or we may want to avoid meats, especially organ meats like liver. And we'd want to avoid high fructose corn syrup sweetened foods such as sodas and alcoholic drinks. Any type of alcohol can raise the uric acid in our blood, but especially beer. As you can see, high uric acid levels is an important risk factor for cardiovascular disease, heart attacks, and strokes. Thank you for watching. Like and share the video with friends and family. Subscribe to the channel so you can support the channel. And until the next video, stay healthy and stay safe.